The university is proud by honoring the above personalities. We are proud to fulfill our obligation of recognizing the invaluable contribution of these towering personalities of our country in their global acclaimed domains. It is heartening to note that the university has spread its arms to various facets of educational diversity and presently encompasses 20 departments catering to engineering and technology, humanities, science, management, law, computer applications, commerce, architecture, pharmacy, and has an enrolled strength of around 5,000 students. The faculty base of the university is extremely attractive, with most of the faculty members having PhD qualification from leading institutions of the country and the world. In this year's convocation, graduates' degree will be awarded to 1,323 students. Postgraduate degrees will be awarded to 361 students, and 19 scholars will receive their PhD degree. 119 medals will be presented to students and scholars in recognition of their attainments. On behalf of the university, I extend my warm congratulations to the recipient of degrees and prizes after years of their intense rigor. Sir, in today's convocation, as many as 19 scholars shall be receiving their PhD degrees on very meaningful researches undertaken by them towards upliftment of the society as well as contributions to science and technology. There are various funding agencies, including DST, CSIR, ACRB, who had been funding innovative and meritorious research work undertaken by our faculty members. Sir, I'm happy to report that our faculty members are engaged in bringing out some of the outstanding books, articles, and papers in pursuit of their scholarly achievements. TCS designed AICT approved Computer Science Business System, CSBS course from the academic year 2019-20, where industry expertise of Tata Consultancy Services has been embedded in this four-year BTEC program.
Distinguished members of the audience, my dear students and friends from the media, at the very outset, I thank the Techno India University for inviting me to be the chief guest at its first convocation being held today. This university was established under an act passed by the West Bengal Legislative Assembly in the year 2012. I am told that this is the first private university in the state of West Bengal and that it is the forerunner in offering the most advanced courses. It has established itself as a leader in the field of unique job creation. From its inception, the university has successfully laid emphasis in the matter of collaborations with leading industries to facilitate an industry-centric environment for the students and other stakeholders.
Doctor of Philosophy in Management.
Sri Devashish Roy, IPS, put our hands together for the second alumni in the PhD list.
Prashanji Pramanik, Doctor of Philosophy and Science.
Prashanji Pramanik.
Author
Roy,
Doctor of Philosophy and Science.
Author Roy.
Multi Nayak, Doctor of Philosophy and Science.
Multi Nayak.
Rupa Banerjee, Doctor of Philosophy in Science.
Rupa Banerjee.
Shampa Mitra, Doctor of Philosophy in Science.
Shampa Mitra.
Upashana Dutta, Doctor of Philosophy in Science.
Upashana Dutta.
Pritam Mukherjee, Doctor of Philosophy in Science.
Pritam Mukherjee.
Devasis Pachaudhari, Doctor of Philosophy in Management.
Devasis
Pachaudhari. Sri Arpan Mitra, Doctor of Philosophy in Management.
Sri Arpan Mitra, Honorary Councillor of Burundi.
Ashish Vandan, Doctor of Philosophy in Science.
One of the most important factors which can contribute to the growth of the country is development of technology and industry. Innovative entrepreneurship and skill development are the need of the hour. I am happy to know that this university can justifiably claim to be an architect in this direction. The university is also doing commendable work in the area of emerging technologies and has set a mark in the domain of contemporary research. Convocation is one of the most important events in the life of a student receiving a degree. I congratulate all the students who have received their well-earned degrees today. But they must remember that convocation is not an empty formality confined to giving and receiving the degrees only. Learning does not end with the convocation. It is a continuous process. Students of technology must know that technological developments cannot be achieved by remaining status quo. An inventive mind always searches for new directions, new reasons and causes. New questions arise as a consequence, and this provides incentive for research and deep analysis. This process is unending and will continue with the persons of curious, questioning and innovative minds. Dear students, always remember that behind your success culminating with the award of degrees to you lie the blessings, hopes and sacrifices of your parents or guardians. All the teachers, professors and academicians who have worked tirelessly in assisting you in pursuit of knowledge and success deserve to be lauded as well. I also felicitate your parents and well-wishers who have supported you throughout your journey. You have received the instructions, or rather, I can say, a very good encouraging lecture from your chancellor and other speakers. And I hope they will abide by the oath or by the sermon which you have taken received today. And thank you for inviting me to this function. Jai Bhai.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.